What is up, guys? Awesome Nerd Show here, and today we're unboxing the Marvel Legends series for Thor Ragnarok. So, of course, I know you can't see all the figures exactly in the camera, but that's why we'll open them and go through each one, see what all they come with and who they are and everything. But down here, of course, we have Thor. So this is just the normal Thor, Loki, and Hela over here. So she's the bad guy. These are all characters from Thor Ragnarok, which it says on the bottom, but you obviously can't see. And so those are going to be all Thor Ragnarok characters. Then up here we just have Thor characters, which I know you can't see anything but the lower. But here we have the current Thor, which is Jane Foster's. And then we have Ares, which is just another, like, god type, obviously, the god of war, Ares. But a god in the whole Thor universe. And then we have Odinson, which I believe is Thor, now that Jane has taken, or the girl Thor has taken over as Thor, or whatever, from Thor, whatever you want to call it, the actual Thor. And so now he's just called Odinson, I believe, if that's correct. And then, of course, all these have parts that, you know, can come together to build a character. And it's pretty dang awesome because it is the Hulk from Thor Ragnarok. And so he's got all his armor and stuff on it. And so, like, you can see the head of it right here and stuff. And then all this has a bunch of armor and legs and stuff for him. So I'm pretty excited to build this all together. So let's go ahead and open them and go through each one. And then we'll build Hulk at the end. Okay, so first up here we have the Thor character, and so this is the Thor from the movie, so Thor Ragnarok, and so this is the Chris Hemsworth character and stuff here, or his version of it, and so this is going to have reference to a lot of Thor Ragnarok, so if you haven't seen it, what's wrong with you? It's such a good movie, and if you didn't see it, we do have a review of it here on the channel, so you can go back and check that out. It'll, of course, been from last Saturday, I believe, or whatever time of this going up. So you can go check that out and see what we thought of the movie exactly. But this is, as I said, the Chris Hemsworth Thor Ragnarok version. So this is him from the battle arena. And so he has the helmet on, which in the commercial has the little ear things that, like, fold down to give him, like, his classic helmet look. Which you can see the side, like, wings there off the helmet. It's got the blue and red all over it, which is, like, the color of the Grandmaster's arena. It's all the blue and red, which I really like that color scheme, like the lighter tealish blue with the red. I really like the way the colors all go together and stuff. And so this is his armor that he has to wear, which is pretty much just his normal clothes, but then he has, like, this leg armor on there, and then the shoulder, and then, like, set all the paint all over him to go with the arena, and then the helmet. And then he has his cape, which is kind of, like, falling off. It's not sticking very well. It's got, like, a part over here that can stick in. But this is his torn-up cape because, I forget who exactly did it in the movie, but someone, like, tore off half of his cape, so he's got, like, this half cape going around and stuff, but you can take it off. It does have a, like, pegs that sticks inside of his chest that you can, pull out and then take it off if you want, and then it has a leather strap here, kind of, like, help holding it on or whatever, but, yeah, this little side thing over here that it has doesn't hold anything. And so, of course, he's got his belt and all, like I said, all his, like, normal clothes, I believe, that he wore into the planet of the where he gets captured and everything. But then he just adds on some pieces of armor to fight in the arena. And to go along with that, to help him fight, we got two swords, which I don't remember exactly. I mean, I'm sure since they're in here that he probably used these in the fighting arena. Of course, they got that blue, tealish color. It's kind of hard to see in the light. But I don't remember exactly him using these, but he probably did. I just don't remember. But he's got two swords, so you can obviously use that to help him fight and everything. And just some information on Thor from the box here says, with his worthiness called into question, Thor must fight to preserve the legacy of Asgard and the godliness that he once claimed. So obviously he, with the bad guy coming in, kicking him out, or he gets, not really kicked out, but he gets off track from Asgard and then gets captured on this planet and has to fight to get free, and he has to fight the battle arena, or the champion, whatever, of the arena, which turns out to be, and goes along with this, Hulk. And so we, for the build a figure, whatever you want to call it, we get the Hulk's head from this, and so we got Hulk there with the paint on it, which he has in the arena. To me, the face doesn't really look like the Hulk from the movie, but it's not like a horrible-looking Hulk or anything. But yeah, he does have the paint, which, again, he wears in the arena as the champion. And then it also comes with his helmet, so you can stick it in. But well, obviously when we put it all together, you will see it a lot better. So there we have like Hulk inside the big giant like Spartan helmet, again with more paint on it, which I think is really cool. Which I do have to say about this, this is probably one of the coolest sets I've seen or done videos on, because each person comes with weapons, like different weapons. They all come with like other stuff. So like Thor has his cape, a lot of them have capes and stuff. And then like the Hulk comes with a bunch of weapons and armor and stuff. So it's just a whole, you get a lot of worth for your money instead of just, oh, here's a character, doesn't do anything, doesn't come with any weapons or anything. You actually get a bunch of stuff. But that's going to be it for this Thor. And next up here we have the Loki. So again, this is the Tom Hiddleston version from the Thor movie. So this is from Thor Ragnarok. So he has the arm or clothing or whatever he wears in the movie here. All the greenish, it's more of a green-blue than the blue-green or whatever of the like battle arena. Because like the battle arena colors are like this one here, which I don't know if you can see very well. And then he's got like a more of a green, darker green color there. But so there is the face, if I can get in the camera, of Tom Hiddleston there. And of course the hair, the way he has it designed. He does come with a cape which can be detached. And the only thing that really helps hold it on is his hair laying down on top of it. That's the only thing that really keeps it on. And then of course his, like I said, his suit. He's got purple on his arms, which I really like the purple added into the colors. And then his belt there, or I guess, I don't know if that's a belt because it's really high up. And then just shoes and stuff like that. Which I'm confused about the clothing, whether he's wears normal clothing and then has like the armor and stuff added on from the battle arena, or from Sakaar, I think is the planet, and the Grandmaster and all that stuff, or if that's just what he was wearing and it just happened to coincidence with, or be a coincidence with the colors and stuff. So as I mentioned, he does come with the cape, so that's like one of his accessory things. So it's got the same color, the bluish green whatever on the outside, and then a yellow on the inside going along with his colors. And then I think that's really cool to go along with it is you do get his crown as well. So his crown with the two giant horns on it. And so if you do get it adjusted correctly, it does look really pretty good and decent whatever on his face. Like with something adding another piece of armor, or especially a thing on the head, they look really weird on figures, especially when it comes to like hats and stuff. But this actually looks fairly decent. I can't get it in the camera here. Like I said, if you get it adjusted right and everything. So he's got his big giant horns, as you can see there. And it just looks really cool. I love the way that looks. And so on Loki's box, it says, "Forever a trickster, Loki's allegiance are often unclear. However, one thing can be said for certain. Loki always looks out for Loki's best interest." Ain't that the truth? Especially if you see the movie. You see that once again. And then, of course, for the Build-A-Figure Hulk, we get Hulk's right leg here. So you can see his big, giant, meaty leg and foot there. See all his toes and his like gladiator shoes and stuff. And I just think it looks really cool. So just for a size comparison, he's about half a Loki. So I don't think he's going to be super ginormous compared to some, but he's obviously going to be bigger. And so that is the Loki. And then next up here we have Hela, the big baddie from the movie. And so she's the one that's trying to take over Asgard and claim as herself. And then we'll of course find out that she has some relation, I should say, to Hulk, or to Thor, sorry. In case you haven't seen the movie, I don't want to spoil everything. But would give her some claim to Asgard and stuff. And so as I said, she's a big baddie, so I really like this. She is in all her green, so of course kind of goes with her design of like Loki and stuff. The bad guys are always dressed in green, I guess. But she's a lot of green. It's hard to hold her up. She's so, like, her head thing is so big, which is cool. It's like big giant antler things almost, and just all the design and detail in it is just pretty cool. It looks very dangerous and almost just feel like stab, you could like stab somebody with them. And so then again, she's in all her green. She's got her headdress thing on, and then it covers parts of her face and around her eyes and stuff. And then again, she's all green. She's got, you know, black fingernails and stuff. She's just really a nasty looking person. All green. She's got a green cape, which the cape again is another thing of hers. It doesn't stick on. It's just a peg in her back, and it's kind of loose, and like the way the box held it in, it's like all bent and stuff. So the little like shoulder pads don't really line up or go where they're supposed to, and yeah, it just moves real easily. So the cape's not very good on her for like holding her or anything. And then of course with her we get just, you can switch out their heads to just her normal head. So this is the Kate Blanchett plays Hela here, and so this is like more of her face that you can see. just darkness around her eyes, and then her hair there. So then when she, like, starts to find stuff, her head gets covered up with this armor piece with all the, like, antlers on it. So she comes with that, and then she also comes with her sword, which in the movie she just, she uses, like, a sword like this. It's hard to see because it's all black. A sword like this to fight with and stuff, and then she also pulls out, like, little daggers or something that look like this that she, like, just throws at everything, which I think that's one of Hela's powers, is that she can, like, summon any weapon, like, that she can think of, so she can just, like, think of any sword, and it just appears in her hand and stuff, and so that's why she's able to, like, control and just completely pull stuff out of nowhere. And so that's the Hela stuff. So let's see. The box says, Ragnarok obsessed super being, Hela threatens the balance of kingdoms of her on her quest for power and domination. So then she's the baddie, out looking for stuff, trying to take control of everything. And then with Thor here, I keep calling it Thor, Hulk, we get Hulk's right arm. And then again, like I said, mentioned with Hulk, he does come with weapons. So we get like an axe thing here. So like kind of like a battle axe. So it's got the blade on one side and the a sharp point on the other side, so you can like kill people with either side. And it's just a big, giant, like, rusty metal object. Because, of course, with Hulk, he has to have bigger things because he's ginormous. And so I feel like a lot of these things are, like, made out of, like, car parts and stuff. And we'll see one coming up. And I feel like it's car parts and stuff like that that makes up these things. But so there's the Hulk pieces. And so that's going to be it for Hela. And then next up here, we have the Kerr Thor. So again, this is not from Thor Ragnarok or anything. This is from the actual comics. These other three, so her and the other two, are a part of the comic book series. And as I mentioned earlier, this is the current Thor. So this is the female Thor that kind of caused controversy or whatever, that they made Thor into a girl. But I believe it's Thor became unworthy somehow. So he did something, obviously, and so he became unworthy. So he lost the control of Mjolnir, so his, like, hammer or whatever, and so it got passed on to another person that was worthy, and it chose the girl, which is Jane Foster. So if you've seen the Thor movies, this is who Natalie Portman plays. So just like Natalie Portman becomes Thor, but of course a girl version. So in this, she has her helmet, which of course we'll bring up close here. So she has her helmet, which isn't, like, severely different from Thor's. Like, obviously it covers more of her face. It goes down to her nose. She has this logo of some sort. I don't know exactly what that is exactly. Kind of looks just like the logo of Asgard. She has a point on her head, which is kind of funny. Which I know the old classic Thor had a little small point at the top, but that's kind of cool. Then it's got the giant wings and stuff. So then we got her hair, her cape, which again, she comes with a cape. And it's falling off and, again, not held on very well. Then she's got her armor, of course, with it being female, they always have to have their stomach showing or whatever. Then she has a belt with, material that hangs down, so I forget what they call it, kind of like a skirt type thing or something. A piece of armor on her arm. And then she's got her shoes, which are kind of like, look like Ares or Hermes shoes because they have the wings on them and stuff. So metal, obviously armored shoes with little, like, the Thor wings on them. And then, as I mentioned, her cape, which is very similar to Thor's actual cape. But, like I said, for her, it's kind of loose and just moves around. And it's just held in by a peg in the back. So there is the Thor there. And then, of course, if she's Thor, she needs Mjolnir, which, again, I don't know if that's exactly how you say it, but that's just how I call it. And so we have the hammer here. So she has Thor's hammer that you can stick in her hand, but it's going to be hard to currently. And so it just looks really cool. I like all the detail they always put into the hammers with all the design and everything and all the handle leather work and then, of course, the piece hanging down and stuff. And it just looks super cool. So there is that. And it says, deemed worthy to raise the mighty Mjolnir, Jane Foster claims the mantle of Thor, goddess of thunder. So instead of god of thunder, she's goddess. And so there's her. And then, of course, for the Hulk stuff, we get the left leg of Hulk. So there we get that. And then he also comes with a piece of shoulder armor. So again, we'll put this around his body or whatever to be a piece of armor for his shoulder. It's hard to see exactly what it is, but it goes just around his shoulder. And so that's it for the Jane Foster Thor. And next up here, we have Odin's son, which, like I said, I'm not exactly 100% sure on this, but I believe this is Thor after he became unworthy in the comics. So again, this is not a movie version or anything. This is the Thor from the comic book series, which kind of fits in with Thor Ragnarok because this is what Thor would be, like I said, if this even is Thor. B, when he lost Mjolnir in the movie, like you see in the commercial and stuff, and then went off to, like, you know, gain power and stuff. And so this is what he becomes. And so he's got armor very similar, not armor, but clothing very similar to the Jane's, like, underneath. So, like, the black, and then it has the same, like, button design where hers was, like, on her stomach. His is up on his chest. He's got part, what's left of his cape. And so you can see it's all tattered and torn and holy and everything. He's got a rope belt. Some pieces of, like, leather on his wrist. And then... again, very cheap clothing held up by leather and, you know, ropes and stuff. So he's not doing very well here at all. Very unworthy Thor. And then because of that, he doesn't have the power of Mjolnir or the use of it or whatever, the hammer. And so he has an axe instead. So he has this axe, which again, looks cool, but it's looks kind of like cheap. And it's, of course, bent because of the toy and the way they keep it in the box and stuff. But it doesn't look anything nearly as cool as Mjolnir or anything. It's just like an axe he could find just in an armory or something. So he has that he can use, obviously, to get in his hand like that. And he has an axe now. And for Thor, it says Crusaders of the... oh, because he goes with Ares. So I maybe will wait to see that read that with Ares. But as I said, if I believe I am correct, which I don't know if I am, that this is Thor. So you can pretty much just take everything about Thor and just make it where he's lost the power of Mjolnir. And he's become unworthy, as they say. And so now he's just trying to... get through and survive without the power of Mjolnir and stuff. And so that is... oh, wait. First off, I forgot about Thor, or Hulk. So we have Hulk's upper body here. So again, it's the armor, or the arena one, so he has the paint down his chest now, too. So it goes down his helmet, to his face, and now down his chest. And then he has, like, the, like, Spartan... I don't know what you call these. I call it, like, skirt, but I don't know exactly what you call them. But the, like, armor pieces with, you know, all the dangly stuff. To wear, and then he's got no chest plate, but he has the armor piece that we saw that you put on, like, his shoulder and stuff that covers part of his chest, and then part of his legs and stuff. So, again, if you, like, line him up with Thor here, Odinson, whatever, he's pretty much half the body, again, still, or more. And so that's going to be it for Odinson. And last up here, we have Ares, which is a really cool figure out of the set. Like, I don't know much about it. I know he's one of my brother's favorite characters, which, again, if you haven't seen all these videos, all the Marvel Legends are my brother's. Thanks, that's why I do it. He buys them. I do a video on them and everything. So he really likes this. This was a pretty cool one, or one he was excited for, which he does have. They did a Build a Fairy figure Ares years ago. And he really wanted it, so I ended up buying it for like $200 or something. Like, that's how much it was selling for. And then, of course, now they come out with an Ares that looks almost identical. And, of course, it's got upgrades to make it look a little better and stuff. But I think size-wise, it's probably smaller since it's not a build figure and stuff. But you never know. And so this is Ares, who's one of the characters from Thor. I don't know a whole lot about him. I don't know if he's good or bad. I want to say he's bad, but then I think, again, he may be good. Like I said, my brother probably make fun of me for not knowing this stuff. But we have Ares here, which, again, Ares is a god of war in Greek mythology and stuff, so not exactly sure what he fits into here in the Thor universe with Norse mythology and stuff like that. But we have Ares here, which, again, this is a cool character because, first off, he has a helmet, so it's like a Spartan helmet-looking thing here that you can take on and off. So there's his face, and this is not the Ares from the Wonder Woman movie. Same, like, character in general, but obviously different universes. One's Marvel, one's DC. But there is Ares' face there. And again, I like the whole helmet taken on off. He has, like, a pirate-looking logo there on his chest. But it's a skull with two swords, obviously. He's got leather and armor around his arms. He's got a sheath thing here on this side with comes with a small little sword. Which, that's the thing about Ares' weapons. They look really weird. Like, this doesn't look very ominous or dangerous. This is the way it looks, like the design and stuff. But obviously, I know it's a toy, but they can make it look a little more dangerous. And of course, he's got these big armor, like knight's armor looking things on his feet there that he has. Looks like I said, piece of like a knight's armor or something, which his helmet just keeps coming off. And of course, with any god of war, you need weapons. And so he comes with a sword very similar to the knife. Obviously, it's bent, again, because of the box. But same like look and design, but obviously giant because it's a sword. And, again, just doesn't look very dangerous. Looks like a really fat sword that wouldn't, like, do much damage or anything. But he carries a giant sword around. And then to go also with it, he comes with an axe. So, again, he's just got three weapons with him, a helmet. So they all just come with a bunch of different pieces of weapons and stuff to go along with it. So again, he has a giant axe now to go too. So he's got a big axe to grind, if you could say. But yeah, so that's really cool that he comes with all these weapons. And so now I'll read the thing on them, because obviously he's paired up with Odinson. And so it says, Crusaders of the Realm, these warriors wield ancient weapons in their fight to bring back balance to the kingdoms from which they hail. So again, not really sure if he's good or bad, but I guess it doesn't really matter. And then for our last pieces of Hulk here, we get Hulk's left hand. So we now have all the pieces for Hulk that we'll set aside. And then he also comes with his giant, like, hammer. I would say axe, but it's not an axe. But giant, like, hammer thing that he uses in the arena battle with Thor. And to me, this kind of looks like a radiator, almost, I think is what they called for Makar, with all the, like, piston things sticking up or whatever. Not exactly sure if it is, because it doesn't really look like one, but they could have, like, welded a bunch of parts together. But it just looks super cool and, like, dangerous and stuff. And so that's going to be it for Ares. And so now we can put Hulk together. Obviously, I don't think he'll fit all in the camera here. So we've got his legs, his torso, both of his arms, his weapons, which will just sit over here to the side, his head in the armor piece, so you can take that off. And then, of course, the part that goes around his shoulder, chest armor piece, or whatever and stuff. So we have all the pieces now, so I'll go ahead and put them all together and then be back to review. Okay, so I got Hulk together now. And he actually wasn't that bad. The only problem I had part with was this leg here. For some reason, it wouldn't want to pop into the joint or whatever. But I thought, you know, with the shoulder piece and everything here, that it would be super hard to get on. But it's actually super easy. Just put this arm on, slide it on over, then pop the other arm on. And the arms went on super easy. Usually, they're the hardest parts to deal with and stuff. So here we have Hulk in all his armor. So again, he's got the headpiece that comes on and off. I like the way he looks with it. Out it, like, I like the way his face looks, but it's just, so this is one of the helmets that you can try and adjust, but he still looks weird no matter what, but it looks cooler with it on though. Like, the in general, I like the look of it. So again, he has the piece of armor here, all the paint again down his helmet, down his face, down his chest, and everything's just like going straight down. But he's got all his armor on this arm, and then of course not much on this, which I don't know if it's because of usually people are dominant with their right hands, and so they use weapons and stuff, so they, without armor, they can have more range of movement and everything. Then they have the weapon to help protect that side, where this side they don't really have the weapon, so they have to, like, armor up more and can use it to, like, you know, block and stuff like that. But he's got the armor all on this arm, and then not much except for there on the hand and wrist and stuff. And then of course has the whole, like, skirt type thing, gladiator skirt, and then some padding or things there on his legs. I don't know exactly sure what they are. And then of course he's got the gladiator sandals looking thing there with all the different straps on it and stuff. So he just looks super cool. I tried to put the weapons in his hands, so the giant, like, hammer and the axe, but they're hard to get in. I couldn't get them in very well. But that just looks super cool. And then just for size comparison, again, I know Hulk's not fitting all the way in the camera, but there, I think their feet are about lined up, so you can see the size difference. So not as big as Hulk, like, truly should be, or at least the movie-wise he should be. Or at least I think he's a little bit bigger. But it's still, they did make it bigger, which is always good. But that's going to be it for this Marvel Legends Thor Ragnarok set, or just Thor in general set, with the Build-A-Figure of Hulk here, which looks super cool. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a thumbs up for me. Leave any comments you have down below, which character was your favorite out of this set. And then don't forget to hit the subscribe button to see more. And we'll see you next time.